Hi, the topic is graph traversal technique that comes in fifth unit of analysis and design of algorithm. In this discussion, first we'll discuss about the basic introductory part of the graph traversal. What are the different techniques in graph traversal and application area where we can use it. In next section, I'll take an example and give you the way through which we can use the breadth first search in given graph. In last section, I'll take the example again and I will show you how the depth first search approach can apply in a given graph for the traversal purpose. So let's start with the introductory part. So what is graph traversal? Here you have a graph as an example over here into the screen. You can see. So what is graph traversal? Once we are visiting all the vertices of the given graph, then it is known as the graph traversal. So here, whenever we talk about the traversal, we'll have always two keywords. One is a visiting, another one is a exploration. So what is visiting? We reach into a particular vertex that is known as the visiting to a node. Once we will visit to a particular node, then next approach what we can do, we can explore it. It means we can find out all the adjacent node of the given graph. Like here, node 1, once we'll reach into this one, node 1, then it is known as the visiting. And once we'll explore it, it means whenever we try to find out the adjacent node of that, like 2 and 7 is the adjacent node of 1, then it is known as the exploration. For that purpose, we use the two different techniques. One is a breadth first search approach and second one is a depth first search approach. Actually, breadth first search approach uses the level order searching and depth first search using the pre-ordered traversing. So if I'll say what are the application area of the graph traversal, very well known application areas are computer network. Whenever any two digital devices has been connected for the communication purpose, it means they are passing message to each another in different format, like you people are talking mobile, if you are sending a mail to someone, then what happened? This message has been transferred in within a network and it will reach into the destination point. So how this particular path is going to be find out from source to destination? For that purpose, graph traversal technique is very useful. Just now we have taken two approaches, branch and bound approach, in my previous lecture, even though backtracking was there. So I already told you branch and bound approach use the breadth first search approach to generate the solution, and backtracking approach use the depth first search approach for the generating of solutions. So these are the three basic common application area where we can use this graph traversal technique. Okay, now let's start with the breadth first search approach. What is breadth first search approach? Here you have one tree over here. You can see this tree is nothing but the spanning tree of any given graph. So first I will tell you what is level. Actually, see, 1 is in a level 0, 2 and 7 is in level 1, 3, 8 and 5 is in level 2, and 4 and 6 is in level 3. So breadth first search approach perform the operation level by level. Until all the nodes in at particular level is not going to be explored, you cannot go into the next level. So if I'll start from the level 0, in level 0, one node is there. So that's why first we need to visit this one, then later on we'll explore it. If we are exploring this one, then we are getting 2 and 7 over here. Now all the node in level 0 has been over because only one node was there. Now we need to come into the level 1. In level 1, we have two nodes, 2 and 7. Then one by one, we need to explore it. First, we need to explore 2 and then later on we'll explore this 7. If we are exploring this 2, then we are getting 3 and 8 over here. And once we'll explore this 7, then we'll get the 5 over here. Now this level is over because 2 and 7 only it was there. Rest of the nodes are not present over here. That's why now we can go into the next level. Now, if you are coming in level 2, then we can see here we have 3 nodes, 3, 8 and 5. Then one by one we'll explore it. First we'll explore this 3, then we'll get 4 and 6 over here. Then we'll explore 8, but no child is there. Then we are not getting anything over here. Then afterwards we'll explore this 5. By this way, we perform the operation level by level. That the same concept uses the breadth first search approach. So here you can see the sequence 1, 2, 7, 3, 8, 5, 4, 6. It was there, the traversing or, you know, searching path by using the breadth first search approach. Okay, let's take the example. Suppose that here we have one graph and we need to find out the sequence of by using the breadth first search approach. So for that purpose, we use the Q data structure. Q data structure is well known. Here you can see we have two end in Q. First is front end and second one is a rear end. From rear end, you people are inserting the data element into the Q, and from front end, you people are deleting the element from the Q. It follows the FIFO order. It means the data element which is going to be inserted first, that would be deleted first. Okay, so let's start from the vertex 1 or node 1. Once we'll start from the node 1, first we need to visit it. Once we'll visit it, then we will have a one array and we'll write this element into this array at given specified position if we are visiting it. So as we can see, 1 has been visited, so that's why 1 has been written into this first position. And even then the same time we'll create the spanning tree of all the nodes, whatever node is going to be visited and explored. So like 1 has been visited, now we have written over here. Okay. So now if we have visited 1, then we need to explore it also. So if we are exploring this 1, you can see I just crossed it. It means what happened, once we are inserting the element into the queue, and whenever it is going to be explored, that will delete it from the queue. So as the one is deleted from the queue for the exploration purpose, that's why it has been crossed. You can say that it has been deleted from the queue. So now if we'll explore this one, so it means we need to find out the adjacent node of this one. So here two adjacent node is here, 2 and 7, we are following the order. That's why first it will insert 2 over here in second position, then later on 7 will be inserted into the third position. So in the same time we have to create the spanning tree. So as I have created a spanning tree, so 1 is here at the root position, then left child is 2 and the right child is 7. Now what is our task? Now we have to explore this 2, because see what happened in queue, we can delete the element from the front end only. At the front position, 2 is here. So that's why first we need to explore this 2. Okay, as we are exploring this 2, it means what we are doing, we are deleting it from the queue. So that's why it has been crossed again. So now you please come into the graph here. So if we'll explore this 2, then we have 3 options. Either we can go in the side of 3, only 2 options is here. We can go in the side of 8. So see what we need to take care of, that if any node has been visited, then we cannot visit it again. So like 3 and 8, it was not there in my queue. That's why we can explore it. We can visit it. So from we'll follow the order, to 2 to 3 path will be there. So 3 has been inserted, fine. Then 8 will be visited. So that's why now the 8 will come into the next position. Okay. And the same time we have created the, spanning tree of that. So 2 has been explored. So that's why you can see in the left child 3 is there and in the right child 8 is there. Now what we'll do? Next we'll explore the 7, because 7 is in a front position. Okay, let's explore the 7. 7 has been crossed because it has been deleted from the queue and going for the exploration purpose. So now if we are exploring the 7, we have 2 options. Either we can go in the side of 8 or we can go in the side of 5. See, already 8 is present in our queue. That's why we'll not take it. What we'll take? We'll take the 5. So that's why we can see we have inserted the 5 over here. Fine. And in the same time, I have created the spanning tree. So you are going to visit the 7. That's why you have created one child 5 from 7. Next, we'll explore this 3, because it was there in the front position. So if we are going to explore it, then we'll delete it from the queue. And now we'll explore. We are here at 3 in given graph. So from 3, you have 3 different paths, like 1 is 2, 1 is 6, 1 is 4, 2 is already visited, it was there in my queue, that's why we'll not take it. Then 2 option is here, either we can go in the side of 4 or we can go in the side of 6. So order I'll follow. So first I have taken 4, then later on I have taken 6. So as the 3 has been explored, so spanning tree, please you try to create the spanning tree. Here I have created the spanning tree. From 3, in left child you have 4 and in right child you have 6. Okay, so now what would be next? Then afterwards I have to visit this 8. That's why it has been deleted from the queue. So if we are visiting the 8 over here, you can see you have only 2 options. Either you can go in the side of 2 or you can go in the side of 7. As I know, two, it was there already in the queue. Seven, it was already there in the queue. That's why we cannot visit, you know, we cannot explore eight. So you can see over here, eight has been not explored. Actually, what is this dashed line? This is nothing but the, you know, partial connection. See what happened. When I was visiting this 8, I was having two paths, either go in the side of 2 or either or in the side of 7. So that's why you please see. See all 8 already it was directly connected with 2. But see, as we cannot create the link in between 8 and 7, but unfortunately it was there. They were connected. That's why I have created one dashed line over here. It is not the direct connection. Partially you can say that somehow it is having a relation in between 8 and 7. Okay, next node is 5. So if we'll explore this 5, then we'll go into the graph. Here we can see we have three options, either 6, 4 or 7. Already all these three elements were present into the, you know, given queue. That's why what we can do, we can create the partial line. We cannot explore this 5 because all the elements has been already explored. That's why what we have done, we have created this partial connection between 5 to 6 and 5 to 4. Then next element is 4. So if we'll this explore 4, then we have once again two options, 3 and 5. They have been already, you know, generated or explored. That's why no need to perform any task. And in between 4 and 3, 4 and 5 partial lines would be there. So 4 and 3 have direct connection, 4 and 5 have the partial connection. Then the last element is 6. So if we will explore this 6, once again we will have two options, 3 and 5, but already they have been explored, so that's why no need to create, it will not get explored. You can see there is no child of 6, but they 6 will have the connection between 3 and 5. So here from 3 it is having the direct connection, and with 5 it is having the partial connection. So at the end of breadth first search, I will try to show you what is the sequence of traversal. So first I have visited 1, then 2, then 7, then 3, then 8, then 5, then 4, then 6. So it has been written over here. Okay, it's all about from the breadth first search. Now please go with the depth first search. What is depth first search? Actually it follows the pre-order traversal. You have already studied in tree traversal technique. This pre-order was there, but it is not actually this is the spanning tree of given graph. So what I will follow here, pre-order traversal. What happened in pre-order? Root node first, then left child, then right child. That is the pre-order traversal. So root node first, then 1 will be there. Root node, then here will come into the left child, then 2 again, it is a root node. So that's where it will get traversed. Then once again we'll go into the left child, 3, once again it is a root, so that's why we'll visit it. Then once again we'll go into the left child, that's why 4. So what happened? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the left child is over. So what, where we'll go? We'll go into the right child. So right child is 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. Then what happened? Then what happened? This left portion is already over. Now we'll go into the right portion. So next node will be 8. Overall this left portion is over. Now we'll go into the right one. Right one, this 7 is root. So that's why it will get visited. Then later on this 5 will visit it. So what is the sequence? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 7 and 5. That has been written over here. So here for the solving the depth first search approach, we use the stack data structure. In stack, what happened? Two operation we perform, push operation and pop operation, and both the operation performed from the one end, that is the top of the stack. Got it? Initially, whenever the stack is empty, then you know very well the top is equals to minus one. Once it is full, then in the top position, top will pointing out. From the same place you can perform the push operation, same end, and from the same point you can perform the pop operation. It follows the LIFO order, last in first out. The data element which is going to be inserted at last, that will be deleted first. Okay, so let's see in this graph what happened. So if suppose that we are going to start from the node 1, so first it will get visit. So if it will get visit, it will come into the first position of this stack. So it is here. Now once we have visited, then what is the next task? We need to explore it. So exploration means we need to find out the adjacent node of that. So adjacent node of this one is 2 and 7. Fine. So first we'll this visit 2. So 2 comes here, then we'll visit 7, then No, that is not happening in depth first search. I'm sorry about that. Actually, in depth first search, we perform the operation depth wise. It means in each level, we'll pick one node, we'll explore it, then we'll go into the next level, then once again, we'll take a single node in the next level, then we'll explore it, then we'll go into the next level. Once again, we'll explore it, and until we are not reaching into the particular direction of depth, we'll perform the same operation. Then we'll start from the next depth. Okay, fine. So that's why, as we have taken one, then we'll explore, then we have two options, either two or seven. We'll follow the order, we'll take two first. So two, it has been stored into the stack. As the one has been explored, that's why it has been crossed. It means it has been deleted from the stack. Now, 2 is in a top position of the stack. So now 2 will be get explored. If we'll explore this 2, then we have once again two options, either 3 or 8. So we can choose any one. So I'm following the order. That's why I'm going to visit this 3 over here. As the 2 has been explored, that's why 2 has been crossed. So 3. Now the 3 will get explored. If we'll explore this 3, we'll get either 4 or 6. So there is any one we can choose. So we can go in the side of 4. So that's why 4 has been stored into the stack and 3 has been deleted from the stack. What happening each and every time I'm creating the spanning tree? So first 1 has been visited, then 2 has been visited, then next 3 has been visited, then next 4 has been visited. So what would be next? Next we have to see. Let's see. Okay. So once we'll visit this 4, we have two options. Either we can go in the side of 3 or 5. 3 already has been visited, that's why we'll go in the side of 5. So that's why 5 will store into the top position of the stack. Okay, then we'll explore this 5. If we'll explore this 5, we'll get 6 over here. We'll get 6 over here. 6 is here, and every time we are creating the spanning tree, so 5, then 5, then afterwards 6. Once we are reaching to the 6, you can see there is no path from 3 to 5. Even though you cannot choose this 3, and even though you cannot choose this 5, why? Because they have already already they have explored, they are already visited. That's why what we can do now? Now we need to perform the backtracking. If from this 6 position, you please see in the graph, there is no any other path can get generated. That's why we have to backtrack. Once we'll perform this backtrack, we'll reach into the 5 again, and we'll see, is there any other option? We can see from 5, yes, of course there is other option, that is 7. So then what we'll do? We'll explore we'll visit this 7 over here and deleted this 6 and put this 7 into the top of the stack. If we have visited this 7, now our responsibility is to explore it. Once we'll explore this 7, we'll get this 8. So 7 has been explored, and now at the top position 8 is there. So you can see from 7 to 8 path is there. Now we will visit this 8, and afterwards I'll explore it. Once I'll explore this 8, once again we do not have any other option. We can see 2 has already been visited, 7 already has been visited. So that's why there is no any child created from the 8 onwards. All the node has been visited, explored, traversed. That's why the process has been ended now. So what is the sequence? You can see the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it was following the pre-order traversal. Pre-order, what happened? It will root left, right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7, then 8. It is written over here. So it's all about from the depth first search. So here I'll conclude with my presentation. Depth first search and breadth first search, too, are the graph traversal technique. Both are using the different data structure to perform the operation. They are beneficial in lot of the application in computer networks. So thank you.